So within the context of the system, the question then becomes, what content are you creating and how can you then use that content to provide value for your audience? Hey guys, what's up? Thank you so much for stopping by and checking out my channel as always. For those of you who are new here, my name is Daniel Akinpelu, aka Io, and my goal is to impact the world with music and to inspire and teach you all how to do the very same thing. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about how to provide value in the content that you guys create. As I'm sure most of you guys already know, the society that we live in is structured in such a way that all media revolves around content creation. Corporate enterprises, mainstream brands, celebrities, and social media influencers have all noticed this exact same thing, and that's why they create so much content. Every single social media platform is tailored in such a way that the creators on these platforms create educational or entertaining content that leaves their consumers, their audience, interested so that the owner of the platform like Twitter or Instagram is then able to take the audience that these creators have cultivated and show them ads. So basically, in a sense, the audience that every single creator has is in a way the product, and they're being sold to advertising companies that pay for these ads to run on these different social media platforms. In a very similar way, but on a much smaller scale, social media influencers, small businesses, and entrepreneurs all do this exact same thing. Basically, what each of these individuals or small organizations do is they cultivate an audience, and then for that audience, they create specific content that is then advertisable to outside corporations. That's where you get paid advertisement and ambassadorships and things of that nature, because basically what is happening is that these creators are being approached by companies and are asked to then promote their brands and their products to the audience that they have built up over the years. So within the context of the system, the question then becomes, what content are you creating and how can you then use that content to provide value for your audience? So to answer that question, we first have to ask another question, and that is, what kind of content brings value to an audience? So some of the most common ways that I've seen people do this are through things like comedy, for example, something that'll make people laugh, something that'll bring people in, something that is easily shareable. Another way that I've seen people do this are through things like education. For example, people run Instagram pages and YouTube channels that are dedicated specifically to the purpose of teaching people how to produce music. I've also seen people like Peter McKinnon, who teaches his audience how to edit video, how to edit pictures, and kind of just what the process of creating and editing looks like. I personally try to give you guys an insight to what it looks like for me to create my own music, and I also walk you guys through the process of what it looks like to actually create songs. Along with that, using myself as an example again, I also try to create videos like this that are teaching you guys how to create content that brings value to your audiences. So just as a few more examples into things that actually provide value to an audience, some things that I've written down here are, I've seen people edit their audience's videos, their audience's photos, things like that, and kind of going through the process of how to get certain looks. I've seen videographers and photographers sell their LUTs packs, for examples, and their presets so that other people can use them. That's another form of value. I've seen people do breakdowns of the kinds of gear that they have. For producers, it could be like their monitors or their headphones or their microphones. For photographers and videographers, I've seen people go through their camera bags. For example, Peter McKinnon, using him as an example again because I really love him, he does a yearly update of what he carries in his camera bag. And that's another example of providing value to his audience. Another example, for those of you who are music producers specifically, is that you could also give away some of your time. For example, you can listen back to some mixes that people in your audience submit to you, and you can give them your feedback and your ideas and contributions to what you would add to make their song sound better. Similarly, if you're a photographer or a videographer, you can look through footage and pictures that people submit to you and kind of give them your feedback on what you think could be better or improved upon, or what they did really well with and what they should continue doing. So with that, here are a couple more things that you need to know to make sure that you're able to provide value to the right people. First and foremost, you have to make sure that you're actually engaging with your target audience. Those are the people that are specifically looking for the goods or services or insights that you're providing. So for example, I am a music producer and an audio engineer, and so my specific target audience is those of you who are creatives, but even more specifically, those of you who are music creatives. So a lot of the advice that I give is more generalized so that it's more applicable to a lot of different creative fields, not just music production. However, I have a lot of things that are specialized very specifically for other music producers and other audio engineers. The next biggest thing that I would really, really advise you guys to do is to have original, unique content. And one of the biggest ways that you can do that is by showcasing your genuine personality. Just be yourself. Don't try to imitate or be a gimmick of anybody else, but really, just be your true self. People will gravitate towards that, like I talked about in this last week's video.
Hey, so quick editor's note, I actually wasn't able to post that video last week because as I was going back through the footage, I noticed that my left eye was extremely red for literally the entire video. I think I got like some soap in it or something, but basically I ended up scrapping all that footage and I'm gonna actually re-record it and edit it and post it next Monday instead. So make sure you guys are subscribed so you can see when I post that. And yeah, anyways, let's get back to the video.
You have a unique perspective and a unique personality, so use that to your advantage. That will set you apart from so many other people. And the last tip that I would give you guys on making really, really great advice to provide value for your audience is to make consistent content. After you start creating and you start doing so regularly, people start to expect that content to come regularly. For example, I'm trying my best to do every Monday. I'm trying to get into a good habit of that. I took a little break for a little while, but now I'm back because I know that you guys have expectations of me putting out videos every Monday. And also, with consistency comes growth. You're not really gonna grow unless you stay consistent and continue to put out quality content. So with that, I really hope you guys enjoyed this video and you guys got something valuable out of it. If you guys enjoyed it, I would really, really, really love if you left a like and a comment and you shared it with a friend that is a creative and is looking for new ways to make content. That was a really big pause. Oh man. So with that, I will see you guys next week with a new video on Monday. See ya. Bye.